Although Google Chrome is the most popular browser, it is far from being the best when compared to other browsers. Unlike Google Chrome, other browsers offer extra built-in features and more focus on privacy. Coming up, I'll show you 6 reasons why you should quit Chrome in favor of other browsers, such as Edge or Firefox, as a daily alternative. So, let's get this video going. Number 1 is privacy. Nobody would ever say that Chrome is good for privacy because Google's whole business model is based on collecting user data. If privacy is your thing, then check out these browsers. Firefox has a built-in third-party cookie and tracker blocker by default, and it also blocks fingerprinting, which tracks and collects data about your PC's hardware, software, and other preferences over time, ignoring your indications that you don't want to be tracked, even when you're using private browsing mode. Also, Firefox has introduced total cookie protection, which would prevent tracking companies from following you from site to site by storing cookies exclusively on the page where they were created. When it comes to privacy, Microsoft Edge is certainly not the first that springs to mind. But when compared to Chrome, Edge does offer better blocking of third-party cookies that follow you from site to site. To change your privacy settings, click the menu icon and select Settings. Then the Privacy Search and Services tab on the left, where you'll find the 3 levels of tracking prevention: Basic, Balanced, and Strict. I recommend keeping the settings balanced so that all sites work effectively, but you can play around with the settings that suit you the most. One of the main reasons many users switched from Chrome to Brave is that it is more concerned with privacy. There is no telemetry or spyware reporting back to Brave, as there is with Chrome. To keep you secure online, Brave's privacy practices and policies meet or exceed legislation, and Brave also contains fingerprinting feature as well. Number 2 we have is blocks trackers and ads. If you want to prevent trackers and ads on Chrome, you'll need to download an extension, which means more strain on your CPU and memory. On the other hand, Brave has a built-in function that blocks most trackers and ads. Click on the menu button and select Settings. In the left pane, click on Shields, and under Trackers and Ads Blocking, you have 3 options: Aggressive, Standard, and Disabled. Again, I prefer the standard option to guarantee that all websites function well. Aggressive will block more trackers and ads but may not function properly. Enabling upgrade connections to HTTPS is also a good idea. I would recommend leaving the fingerprinting setting at standard to avoid website crashing. As far as block cookies, many people believe that all cookies are bad, but they are not. Some cookies are created as a way for the website to store your preferences on individual sites, but they also take advantage. The only cookies that concern us are those that follow us from side to side, so we have this set to only cross-site cookies only. Number 3 we have, enhanced performance settings. We all know that Chrome uses a significant amount of your system resources, such as CPU and memory, which causes your PC to run slowly, especially if you have a low-spec device. Since Brave blocks many trackers, ads, and others from loading, it is much quicker than Chrome, and if you have a low-spec PC, you'll be glad to know it's less on resources. Chrome often consumes 3 times the CPU and memory of Brave. Edge, on the other hand, includes built-in performance optimization features. Go to the menu on the top right and navigate to Settings, and then navigate to System and Performance in the left pane. Enabling the Startup Boost under System will reserve a tiny amount of RAM for the browser's process as it runs in the background. Turning on Efficiency Mode and Optimized Performance will lower the CPU load, which is useful while using a laptop to save the battery. If you are gaming on your PC, enable the option below to improve your gaming experience and consume less system RAM. This option will put inactive tabs to sleep after a specific time to preserve system resources. Number 4 is Tor as a built-in feature. This is my favorite feature. Chrome, like other browsers, offers an incognito mode. However, if you choose this mode, it will not save any of your browsing history, cookies, or other site data, which is useful if you share a computer with others, but companies will monitor your data. Brave, on the other hand, takes a step further by including a private mode with Tor connectivity. To access it, click the menu button and choose New Private Window with Tor. This mode will hide your IP address and your data on the internet and your internet service provider. But it is not completely anonymous, so if privacy is your first priority, use the Tor browser instead. Number 5 is Screenshot Tools. If you want to take a screenshot of a website via Chrome, you'll need to install an extension, which means more strain on your PC. Chrome does not have a proper screenshot feature. To utilize the Firefox screenshot feature on any page, simply right-click anywhere within the browser and select Take Screenshot. You may choose to capture only what is visible on your screen or the complete page. You may also choose a portion on the website with a left click and then alter the captured area. You may then copy it to your clipboard or even download it to your PC. Vivaldi also offers a screenshot tool for capturing your screen. In the lower right corner of the status bar, there is a web capture icon that, like Firefox, it allows you to pick the region you want to capture, as well as the entire page, and then you may save it as a PNG or JPEG. Transfer it to your clipboard, or use it in Vivaldi's built-in note-taking tool. Edge, like Firefox, has a screenshot feature called Web Capture. You have two options, Capture Area or Capture Full Page. To utilize it, simply click the Web Capture symbol in the top right corner or look for it in Settings and under Appearance. However, you find an added option, such as Markup Capture here. And finally, at number 6 is Reader Mode. Chrome does include an experimental reader mode, which is, to be honest, dreadful. If you're like me, you might prefer to read an article without being distracted by ads and other website clutter. Then you should check out Firefox and Edge. They have a built-in reader mode, and it works great with just one click. You may enable reader mode in Firefox. In the address bar, click the reader mode icon. There are a few options to modify, such as font type, font size, and so on. You may also alter the color of the backdrop. Edge has immersive reader mode, which can be accessible in the address bar. It provides a clean layout with a plethora of settings to experiment with. There are also grammar tools and my favorite read aloud function, which is pretty fantastic with many options like reading speed, thick of voice, and also choose from various languages. Thank you for your time. If you found this video useful, give it a thumbs up and share it with others. You let us know if you intend to switch from Chrome in the comments. If you're new to our channel, subscribe and click the notification bell to keep up with our latest tech videos and other tech-related updates.